So today I want to talk about why diabetes makes you more susceptible to getting viruses. And more specifically, I'm talking about COVID-19. Being a diabetic triples the mortality rate from this virus. But the question is why? Well, here's why. The virus enters the cell through your own body's receptor. And the type of receptor is this right here, ACE2 receptor. So it goes in there and it starts to replicate. So here's the thing, the more ACE2 receptors you have on your cells, the higher the susceptibility to this virus you're going to be. And diabetics have a lot more ACE2 receptor proteins on their cells. People with high blood glucose have more ACE2 receptors. People that have higher amounts of insulin also have higher amounts of these receptors, and this is why they're more susceptible to viruses. However, there's a couple additional reasons that you need to know about. Number one, the condition insulin resistance. And by the way, about 75% of the population has insulin resistance. So it's very, 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 very common. Insulin resistance can impair your immune response to a virus, okay? But that's not all. People with hyperglycemia, high sugar, which is a lot of people, and I'm talking also about people that are pre-diabetic, have a decrease in neutrophils. Now, let me explain what a neutrophil is. When you have an infection, about 70% of your white blood cells are neutrophils. So they're very, very common. They are basically a phagocyte. They're a cell that eats viruses and bacteria, but primarily they're involved in a lot of viral infections. So when you're diabetic, your neutrophils go down. Now, there are three things that neutrophils do. Number one, they eat viruses for lunch, okay? Number two, they release antimicrobial chemicals that kill pathogens like hydrogen peroxide, okay, and chloride bleach. They actually release bleach and they end up killing the microbes. Number three, they have another strategy using what's called NETS, nets, where they literally put a net over the microbe and dissolve that microbe with the chemicals. One of the problems with neutrophils is they do create a lot of collateral damage because they have these poisons, and sometimes they can affect your immune system. But the point is that if you don't have enough neutrophils, your immune system is going to be compromised, where your body just doesn't have the weapons to fight. So you can imagine this. If you were to send out your troops to battle without any weapons, what's going to happen? This is what happens when your blood sugar is high. And this is why a diabetic has a higher mortality rate with this virus and other viruses as well. Now, if you're a diabetic and you're concerned about COVID-19, the coronavirus, and you continue to eat foods that are high in carbohydrates, then we know you are missing a real key piece to this entire puzzle. Because with some slight modifications of your diet, by cutting out those carbs and decreasing the frequency of your meals, you can greatly improve diabetes, and you can actually improve your immune system as well. So if you're a diabetic, you need to know what to eat to minimize the risk factors. So I put that video right here. Check it out.